History affords few instances of an institution which comes into being as a byword of a people's dream and then exists as living monument to healthcare and medical education. Government Medical College Srinagar is one such institution. Its very name holds a special element of grandeur, as it has been a fountainhead of teaching, caring and research in medical science in the state of Jammu and Kashmir. Celebrating its golden jubilee, the Government Medical College Srinagar has justified the faith which its initiators reposed in it. Having excellence at home and recognition abroad as its guiding principle, the Government Medical College Srinagar has contributed significantly to the development of medical education in our state. It has produced outstanding medical personnel who have achieved distinction both in the country and abroad. Looking back at the glorious 50 years, GMC has emerged as a premier medical college of the country. Apart from nurturing medical profession over the last 5 decades, GMC is providing a healing touch to a majority of population of the state. Government Medical College spearheaded evolution of medical sciences in Kashmir. It witnessed emergence of world-renowned medical professionals. It witnessed diseases and suffering of the outdoor patients. It witnessed hope in the eyes of those admitted. And it witnessed joy on the faces of cured ones. One of the major achievements of this institution is that of making medical facilities available to the rural and the urban people, especially the poor and the underprivileged, directly through hospital catered by GMC and indirectly by producing doctors which are and have been serving throughout the state.
I would say SMHS Hospital has been catering to all strata of the society, irrespective of their economic status, political affiliation, social status. It has been catering to every sector of the society.
It was in 1959 when Colonel S.L. Garg, then advisor to the government, established the Medical College Srinagar.
There was what we call advisor to the government for medical college. His name was Colonel S.L. Garg. Probably most of us don't even remember him. But he is the person who worked here on an honorarium of ₹1 per month. And he established the medical college here, and he had a lot of practical experience because he had worked in Gwalior and other places.
Medical College was located in the erstwhile Emirakadal dispensary, which is now a part and parcel of Lal Ded Hospital, and it was started there. Dr. Garg was doing work for establishment, and we were some junior staff was also selected. We were selected by Public Health Commission by as local junior teachers. One of them was Dr. Ban. He was selected as lecturer in anatomy.
I was the first local person to join the faculty, and the others came a few months later. Then the interviews and other things were held, and a sort of a medical college establishment was started. But the start of medical college as such was in August 1959. Till that time it was all on books.
It was in 1959 that Colonel G.V.S. Murthy took charge as the first principal of Government Medical College, Srinagar. The college was established on the banks of the Jhelum River in the Emirakadal Dispensary. Anatomy and physiology were the first departments started in this dispensary. 2 years later, the college was shifted to the present-day location at Karanagar. On the 25th of August 1961, Government Medical College was formally inaugurated by then Prime Minister of the State of Jammu and Kashmir, Mr. Bakshi Ghulam Mohammed. Soon after the inauguration, a batch of 50 undergraduate students was admitted in the college.
We just passed our FSC, those days it used to be called as FSC, and we were a total of some 28-29 students in our batch, and there was no competitive test at that time. Those students who were eligible for getting admission in the MBBS, and we got admitted, and it was something like dream come true for us.
First lecture was a little bit, you know, now I recall, it was just, you know, I was apprehensive and in presence of the students and to speak to them. So that problem about medical science is that there's so much of advance. I was for teaching physiology. The physiology that I had read 5 years earlier or more was now had changed. So I had to prepare afresh from the latest books.
In 1966, PG courses in preclinical subjects were started. It was in 1968 that post-graduation courses in clinical subjects got underway in GMC.
GMC gradually grew from an undergraduate college to postgraduate college when post-graduation was started in Department of Medicine, Department of Surgery, then Department of Gynae, then Pediatrics, and in paraclinical and preclinical subjects.
With time, Government Medical College started training paramedical staff like radiographers, lab technicians, lab attendants, pharmacists, nurses, and stationary inspectors. 1970s and 80s are considered to be golden period in the history of Government Medical College. At this time, GMC Srinagar had students not only from various states of India but from foreign countries as well.
At that time, I had students from all parts of the country and foreign countries. Students from Malaysia, students from Mauritius, students from Ceylon, and students from the rest of the country, and Kashmir students and Jammu province. And we were admitting at the beginning only less than 100 students to keep up the discipline.
SMHS Hospital was now a major teaching institution imparting undergraduate
and postgraduate medical training in all allied specialities of medicine, surgery and gynecology. At this point, medical services became more specialized and differentiated. It was time for expansion.
Apart from the college expansion, there was enormous expansion of the hospitals associated with GMC, and I have been fortunate to have been closely associated with the expansion and revamping of the hospital structures. In 1980, I became an administrator of the hospitals, and during that period, it is Lal Dead Hospital was upgraded from 100 to 500. Bone and Joint Hospital came into being. Pediatrics was shifted to the separate site, and expansion was in line for other specialties at that time.
One of the major achievements of this expansion was separate 100-bed maternity hospital at Lal Mandi.
I was working as assistant professor, associate professor in the Department of Gynecology. And late Mr. G.M. Sadik was the chief minister. So while I was talking, he was a good family friend. So we were talking about the college and the hospital. So I said that there's so much dearth of maternity beds. So he immediately said, okay, you take over this Lal Mandi Hospital and convert it into a... But it was really a challenge because I hadn't that experience of opening a hospital. But somehow or the other, I had worked in very good hospitals in UK. I, with a very small team, started this hospital, 100 bed. And I tried to run it on the same lines as I had worked in hospital outside, and it became very, very popular.
With increase in population, the 100-bed maternity hospital was unable to cater to the rush of the patients. On the orders of Sheikh Muhammad Abdullah, the hospital was further expanded to the present-day 500-bed Lal Dead Maternity Hospital.
Then Sheikh Saab went round that hospital, he saw it. And he asked me, now what do you want? Because I had been actually nominated to medical college by Sheikh Saab when he was, that time it was the Prime Minister, I think. So he asked me, Girija, what do you want for this? I said, sir, this place is again cramped up, 100 beds is no solution. And there is no land around, but the only land around is this, if it can be reserved for the expansion of 100-bed hospital. And to my surprise, there and then he called his PA, or he said this place is to be reserved for expansion. And then it was expanded to 500-bedded hospital, which it is running now.
A separate children hospital was commissioned at the erstwhile Fruit Mandi.
Likewise, Bone and Joint Hospital was also established for treatment of orthopedic ailments. However, the SMHS became the main focus and buildings started coming up in its vicinity. It was during this period when GMC used to be among the top 10 medical colleges in the country.
Actually, we had a good ratings even in the United States licensing exam. Our students used to get through easily. And we were very proud of our students, our faculty, and the way they were dealing with them. So I think it gradually grew. We had a recognition. We had many international conferences. We had many national conferences. See, our thrust was that we should be communicative with other fraternity members and with other doctors.
69 was the time when I hosted the first national conference of gastroenterology. At that time, this specialty was not developed here, and that gave a platform for me to develop this specialty. And the first national the ninth national conference was held here in the GMC. And after that, in 82, again the national conference was held here. So we had people from abroad, we had people from all over India and this in Srinagar, and that brought GMC on the map of Indian medical schools. And the rating at that time in 1980s went to, I guess it was number 3 or 4 at all India level. Just next to the Vellore Medical College or the Stanley Medical College, maybe King George's, 2-3 medical colleges were ahead, and this college was at number 3 or 4.
The level of teaching was considered towering high. A galaxy of teachers were imparting knowledge to the students, and their level of commitment to the medical education was exceptionally high.
Dedication to the students as well as teaching was the hallmark. And there was examination, there was complete normalcy in a way that we knew that what is going to happen. And that is the time when the medical college gradually inched itself up and up and was considered one of the very best medical colleges of the country.
Apart from education, Government Medical College used to be abuzz with extracurricular activities. Student unions, cultural groups and different clubs were formed.
The students' union, to start with, now became a, we call it a CAS union, cultural, academic, social and sports. So the embodying about four types of activities. So that came into existence.
We used to have social, this annual social gathering, and in those days we also had sports day. We used to have all sorts of games, we used to have music programs, small plays. And all these things are sticking in my mind. I really remember and enjoy those days.
I recollect that during the Silver Jubilee celebration in 1984, we invited people like Amjad Ali Khan, the Sarod Maestro, right, and Sonal Mansingh, the renowned dancer, and they all came. They joined us, and we had a very good program for 3 or 4 days.
Kashmir witnessed turbulent times in early 90s. Post 1989 was a dark patch in the life of this college as well. The examination system derailed, and it took 7 to 8 years for students to complete the bachelor's degree. Many of the faculty members left the college, and the deficiency still persists.
It was a very traumatic period, and I would say time is the greatest healer. All of us have still those scars of last 20 years.
It had its impact because studies were not regular. Even if the teachers would come, students, it would be very difficult for students to come. Even it was difficult for them to appear in the exams. So a normal span of medical education, you know, is four and a half to 5 years. Then at that time, students used to pass MBBS after 6 years, 6.5 years.
In spite of many difficulties and some deficiencies, GMC Srinagar and the associated hospitals are rendering a yeoman's service to the people of the state. Currently, there are 7 associated hospitals of GMC: SMHS, G.B. Pant Children Hospital, Lal Ded Maternity Hospital, Psychiatric Diseases Hospital, Chest Diseases Hospital, Sanatnagar Maternity, Bone and Joint Hospital, Barzala, and Chitranjan Mobile Hospital. These hospitals have the total bed strength of 2,150. On an average,
More than 1,100 patients stay in these hospitals as inpatients, including the floor patients. About 5,000 to 7,000 people throng the outpatient departments daily for medical relief. The hospitals are adequately equipped with 9 surgical theatres and delivery rooms. There are, on the whole, 29 departments functioning. Although the departments are adequately equipped, there remains much to be done to upgrade them to the changing trends in medical care. The bed strength at SMHS Hospital was 750 in 1959, and over the years, it has been increased to the present strength of 1,038. About 2,000 to 3,000 people throng the outpatient department daily for medical relief. The hospital, though located in a busy center, provides a very calm environment inside. The numerous trees and gardens help achieve this serenity. The hospital has a wide popularity. Even people from far-off districts visit it for treatment. Besides these hospitals, it also has an ancillary medical training school where diploma courses for BSc nursing is taught. The faculty of the Government Medical College teaches in 22 departments. Around 1,000 students have post-graduated from this prestigious institution. Doctors, surgeons and medical technologists produced by the GMC have earned worldwide recognition and renown, not only for their excellence but also for their commitment and service. The alumni of GMC has made it famous all over the world. The college has a well-stocked library with over 18,000 books. It subscribes to more than 270 international and national journals and has over 14,000 bound journals. The library has SLIM software, computerized information management system, which allows immediate tracing and retrieval of any publication in library, Medline, an indexing and abstracting service covering over 3,000 international journals. The college buildings are a quaint mixture of the old and the new. While the Dean's Office and the undergraduate wing are located in old buildings dating back to 1876, the main college building was specially constructed in 1956. Its landscaped lawns and an imposing facade houses the main administrative offices. GMC provides broad-based non-academic exposure as well. Students are encouraged to participate in sports and many have excelled in this arena. The college magazine is published every year and the students contribute their write-ups as well. From humble beginnings, it has struck deep roots. As it celebrates its golden jubilee, the Government Medical College Srinagar is poised to extend its healing touch over a large section of people of Jammu and Kashmir, rest of the region and beyond. Over the past 50 years, it has grown in its functions and has become one of the premier medical colleges of the country, and its fraternity of doctors and students are elated to see the GMC Srinagar reach a milestone. The sense of being a part of this fountainhead of healthcare and great institution is shared by both the biggest names of the medical science as its alumni and young students who have come to the institution.